Hi guys, this video is for the guy who asked about, Shabu, for Andrew Craig Bennett. Your question was actually about, his question was, what do I think about the girls who are, my comment regarding the use of drugs by girls in bars in the Philippines. Okay, first of all the words that you said there are true. And I'm not gonna deny that drugs is rampant. Not only in the bars, but also outside, even in schools, even in families, you know. My first time to hear about drugs was when I was in elementary. It's taught in our school that it's bad. They would give us, you know, show us the samples like that, tell us the effects. But I never really got a hold of it until, not hold, but a clear view or understanding until I met, until I moved out with my father, with my stepmom. My stepmom actually, she didn't really become a mother for me, but she did. We became like friends, but yeah. Because I cannot say mom because she didn't really have that motherly care, but I could say a friend because she's good at, you know, telling us advices like that or being strict. I don't really know if she did care about me, but what I do know about is that she told us, me and also her sister told me, actually her family told me, everyone, to take a lesson from what happened to her sister. Her sister didn't work in the bar, but she took drugs when she went to school, and then she got pregnant, and then she got crazy because of drugs until she wasn't able to take care of her two children, and the money she gets for her two children, she used it for drugs. So until she really got crazy that they had to lock her up in the house, and then one time she escaped, she got hit by a car and she died. And now her family, they are taking care of her children. So it's really something bad. In the bar, I'm not really very familiar, but my stepmom's sister worked in the bar before, as well as, my best friend I told you guys a couple of times. They told me about the stories about drugs or something. Sometimes they really don't tell me, maybe because they know that. My stepmom's sister always tells me, but the other one is a little bit still, you know, shy to talk about it to me, you know, something like that. So my stepmom's sister was also offered drugs before when she worked at the bar as a waitress. She told me that it was offered to her by another waitress. The waitress joked to her, it's gonna keep you alive and, you know, your eyes would be open. And it's true, the eyes are too shiny. She told me that these girls, once they take the drugs, their eyes become too bright and they become too alive, like too happy. And yes, they do, they can actually control their weight. Aside from Shabu, which is meth, one of the popular ones is weed. I know that weed is legal in other states in the United States right now, but in the Philippines it's still illegal. And some people really abuse it. And I know it's okay. Some foreigners use it too, even meth, some foreigners use it. But when it comes to, I think some of them avoids it because they might get checked by customs, blah blah blah. But when it comes to bar girls, they're more open. To tell you guys a little bit, it's not only from the gays who put their makeup on, who offers them meth, but also from the other, their suppliers can be the gays, the makeup, the people who puts their makeup. And then some would be the other dancers, especially, usually, and yeah, some waitress, because that's how my stepmom's sister told me about it. But she didn't accept the offer because she had a first-hand experience with her older sister who got crazy. And then the third one was the third people that who could offer this are some of the DJs or bartenders I heard, just a hearsay, and also some the bouncers, and some are the hostmen. If you guys, I already told you about it, the guys who are selling themselves to bar girls, they're not handsome, and some of them uses drugs, and then they would, you know, they would influence the bar girl thinking it's cool and it's good. So what ends up is that the bar girl, what she earns, she will spend it on him, and then they will spend it on drugs like that. It's really sad. We had someone who rented before. She has a boyfriend, a Filipino host boyfriend, and a boyfriend online, foreigner. Instead of using the money for her children from her previous husband, she used it for the boyfriend and drugs. Really, drugs is not really a good thing. Another supplier, this is just a hearsay, but I know it's, let's be honest, it's true, maybe. Some of the police, yeah, they said. There's this, I also heard that the one of the suppliers has a good relationship with the police. So, I think even if everybody knows that, everybody's just quiet. Even me, I don't really know who exactly. I don't even know if it's true or not. But there's a possibility, especially with the Philippines, right? Yeah, corruption. I think, I heard from the bar girls and my stepmom's sister. Because she asked them, because she tried to tell those girls about what happened to her sister. And then she just, those girls just said, it's the way to escape reality, to escape the reality of what they are doing. Because some of them, let's be honest, they didn't want to work in a bar, but they had no choice. So, yeah, and then some of them, it's peer pressure, like, you know, friend, like that, until they get hooked up with it, you know. And then some use it just to look cool because they think it's cool, but it's not cool. And yeah, just those things. In my own opinion, with the girls using drugs, okay, I think I want to say that it's their own life and their own money, but if I had a chance or a choice to actually think or talk about it, I think it's ruining not only their bodies but also their future and their money, really. You know, they work there, they should just save the money that they earn so they can get out of there probably, but they end up using it for drugs, so it becomes a cycle. If they need drugs, they have to work at the bar, then once they get the money, they will do drugs again until they would just realize that they're old and they are not really in what we call in the market anymore. And how can they support their needs, right? Plus, most of them have children. I think drugs not only ruins the family, but in Angeles City, drugs is rampant. It can be like a something like a taboo. Or maybe it's not a taboo. I'm the only one who thinks it's a taboo. But yeah, I think that whoever... I think that drugs is not good. It can ruin not only the person itself, but the people around them. and of course their future. How can I stop it? I don't know, really, I have no answer. Especially nowadays, it's easier to get it, I think. And it's, I guess, cheaper, maybe? I don't know. Hopefully, these women would learn from other people who had the experience of having their lives ruined because of it. But I guess, yeah, peer pressure and, you know, love and, you know, depression really does a big part of their usage. And of course, yeah, the pressure of being sexy and beautiful. And yes, they do. It's he said it's mixed with coffee sometimes. That is true. I even heard some Chinese, you know, we have these slimming coffee, slimming whatever, that are being sold in the market in the Philippines, which are actually banned by the government, but they are smuggled. And I heard those things have drugs. That's why it's no wonder that people really get slim when they take that. But eventually, after they stop, they become really fat. And about weed, if you guys will ask me, moderate usage maybe. But about meth and other things, if you guys use it, I don't really know. But yeah, I learned from my own lesson from my stepmom and my stepmom sister, so I guess it's enough for me to avoid it. So I wish, yeah, these women are more educated and have seen those things as well. Maybe they have stopped, but as of now, I can only comment that I hope they will have better, yeah, judgment on how they would use their money. Bye.